and hopes are high in Argentina for a strong soybean harvest this year. The country is the world's third largest producer of soy after the U.S. and Brazil. Due to the recent weakness of the local currency, the peso, some farmers are stockpiling their soy instead of selling it. And that means less income for the government. Joel Richards has the story.
A strong soy harvest is expected in Argentina, but the current economic climate complicates the bright forecast. David Hughes manages 6,000 hectares in the Buenos Aires province. After this year's currency devaluation, he says the big picture does not tell the whole story.
When you look at the macro level, yes, which is the way the government looks, yes, it looks okay. When you go down, there'll be not all farmers will be in the same position in a year that's going to be high inflation and high uncertainty because the government's changing its economic policy very fast.
Many soy producers have been holding back stock, with some estimates placing the value of withheld soybean at $4 billion. The government sees in that a lot of lost tax revenue.
Producers are expecting, if not a record harvest, then certainly one of the highest in recent years. But the relationship between the government and the agricultural sector continues to be tense after the 2008 dispute.
6 years ago, the Cristina Fernandez de Kirchner government proposed sliding tax rates for soy exports in line with rising global prices. The measure was narrowly voted down in Congress.
Most of the grains increase in its international price by 70% or 80% in a matter of 4 months.
The economy minister at the time was Martin Lustó. He is now an opposition national deputy at Argentina's Congress and still believes changes to the tax system are needed.
When we started trying to implement a mobile tax, export taxation, soy prices were above $600 per ton, and then it came down to $320. So I still think that we need to try to fine-tune our export taxation to the international environment and to the local environment.
The relationship between the agricultural sector and the government is far from repaired, and both still rely heavily on the soybean as hard currency. Joel Richards, CCTV, Buenos Aires.